Yeah, good evening students. We'll get started. So last class I remember doing this problem. Guys, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So last class I remember doing this problem. This example number 5. Express tan inverse of cos of 1 by tan inverse of cos divided by 1 minus 9x in its simplest form. Right. So now we are going to see the derivation for the other two properties. That is, what will happen if you add tan inverse x and tan inverse y, and what will happen if you subtract them. Similarly, the different ways of expressing tan inverse, 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine inverse, cos inverse and tan inverse. We'll start. So the fifth property is, write it down this. So the fifth property is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is what? And tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is what? Okay. Similarly, what is 2 tan inverse x and all those things. Okay. So here, let's start. So let's see, for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, let, okay, tan inverse x be taken as alpha and I'll take tan inverse y as beta. Okay, so what is going to happen to LHS? Alpha plus beta is nothing but tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Accepted. Consider tan of alpha plus beta. What is tan of alpha plus beta, guys? It is tan alpha plus tan beta divided by 1 minus tan alpha tan beta. Right, tan of a plus b is tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. So what is tan alpha, guys? So from this I can write tan alpha is equal to x. From this I can write tan beta is equal to y. Is there any doubt till this step?
No doubt, sir.
So in the place of tan alpha, what can I write? I can write x plus. In the place of tan beta, I can write it as y divided by 1 minus xy is nothing but tan of alpha plus beta. But what is that we need? We don't need tan of alpha plus beta. We need only alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta will be how much? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus x. So the formula for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is given as tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Make a note of this. Done?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is given as tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Okay, so let's see some example problems based on this. Show that tan inverse half plus tan inverse 2 by 11 is equal to tan inverse of 3 by 4. So tan inverse of half plus tan inverse of 2 by 11. So what is the formula? If I take this as x and this as y, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is tan inverse of x plus y
x by, plus 1 by 1 minus x.
So tan inverse of x is how much? 1 by 2 plus 2 by 11 divided by 1 minus half into 2 by 11. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. You will get tan inverse of 11 plus 4 divided by 22, the whole divided by 11 minus 1 divided by 11. So this and this get cancelled 2 times. So tan inverse of 15 divided by 20. So that will be tan inverse of 3 by 4. Is that what they are asking? Yes. Is it clear, guys? Right? Shall I proceed?
1 minute.
Sorry, you're copying it, huh?
Yes, sir. Just a minute. Done, sir.
Okay. Next is, we will see what are the formulae for 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine inverse, 2 tan inverse x in terms of cos inverse, and 2 tan inverse x in terms of tan inverse itself. Okay. So if I take 2 tan inverse x, okay. So let tan inverse x be taken as theta, then what is tan theta? X. Let this be question number 1. Okay. Now, tan theta is x means, how can I write sine 2 theta in terms of tan? Sine 2 theta is 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Right? You guys know this? You guys know this or not?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So 2 times tan theta is x divided by 1 plus x square. From this, what is going to be the value of 2 theta? 2 theta will be sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. But what is 2 into theta? Theta is nothing but tan inverse of x. So 2 tan inverse x is equal to sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Okay. Similarly, you can write 2 tan inverse x as cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. Okay, cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. Similarly, 2 tan inverse x can also be written as tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. How to derive them? We will see it now. Okay. So I'll show you the derivation. Write it down. Property number 6. 2 tan inverse x is equal to sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Similarly, 2 tan inverse x will be equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. What is the proof for it? The proof is very simple. Okay? It's very simple. Consider RHS. If I consider RHS, cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. I will put x is equal to tan theta. That implies theta is equal to tan inverse x. So whenever you are substituting something, no, immediately write the inverse also, so that you will have a clarity of what you need to do when theta comes. So cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So what is 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta? What? What is 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta? You it is cos 2 theta. See, for everything I've done video, I'm not sure how many of you have seen it. I've done a video and I posted it yesterday. If you're not sure of why it is cos 2 theta, I suggest you guys to revisit it. Okay. Now I can only give you the outline. Everything is clearly shown in those derivations. So cos inverse of cos 2 theta is going to give you 2 theta. This is equal to 2 times. What is the value of theta? It is tan inverse of this. So cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by cos 1 plus x square is going to give you 2 times tan inverse of x. Similarly, what is the last property here? 2 tan inverse x is equal to tan inverse of right, again consider RHS, tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. What should I put the value of x as?
Tan theta.
Tan theta.
Tan theta, sin theta, cos theta. I need to put it as tan theta so that theta is equal to tan inverse of x. When you substitute x is equal to tan theta here, tan inverse of 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta, right? So tan inverse of 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta is tan tan 2 theta. So 2 theta will come out here. This will be 2 times tan inverse of x. So you guys are not confident with the trigonometric formula, correct? This whole exercise needs all these manipulations. Immediately after this class, I suggest everyone to go through the YouTube video which is posted in the group. Okay. So I have solved everything. Sir, can you hear us? No. Is anyone speaking?
Sir, can you hear us, sir?
Now it is audible.
Okay, sir. Because we said the answers for the tan theta and all, sir.
You answered it as tan 2 theta, huh?
No, sir. You asked, you know, simple questions before, no, sir. What will we substitute x as? We answered for it.
That time I could hear. That time I could hear.
Oh, okay, sir.
Okay, so this is the outline, guys. Now, based on this knowledge, we will solve some problems. So I have the example problems ready. Yeah. So the sixth problem is write cot inverse of 1 by root of x square minus 1 in its simplest form. So last class I gave you a hint. Wherever you find the root of, wherever you find x square minus 1, what are you going to substitute? Put x is equal to
secant theta plus cosecant theta.
Sir?
Yeah.
Secant theta, sin theta. Rohan AV said the answer, sir.
Secant theta, cosecant theta.
That's what you told, but here what should I substitute? You told or, no, or is an option. Secant or cosecant you told. Should I substitute secant or cosecant?
Sir, you have to substitute cosecant.
Sorry?
You have to substitute cosecant.
You want to substitute cosecant? Actually, you can substitute anything. If I substitute cosecant, then what will be the answer? Cot inverse of 1 divided by root of cosecant square theta minus 1. So this will be cot inverse of 1 by root of cosecant square theta minus 1 is cot square theta. Right? So cot inverse of 1 divided by cot theta. I can get eliminated. I can get rid of this cot inverse only if I have a cot in the numerator, right? So cot inverse of this is going to be tan theta. Correct, Oda?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So tan theta, what I can do is I will write it as cot of pi by 2 minus theta. Right. So cot inverse of cot of pi by 2 minus theta will give me pi by 2 minus theta, or pi by 2 minus, what is the value of theta, guys? It is cosecant
inverse.
So pi minus cosecant inverse x is how much? Look at the third property and tell me. Look at the third property and tell me. So there are, sorry, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2. Cot inverse x plus tan inverse x is pi by 2. Secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is also pi by 2. So pi by 2 minus cosecant inverse x will be secant inverse x. Are you guys clear? So this is the simplest form.
Your fourth property was.
Fourth property. Yeah, third one is that cot inverse, cos inverse of minus x, no?
Yes, sir.
So pi by 2 minus cosecant inverse x is secant inverse x. Correct? So the question is, I told you guys, you can either substitute cosecant theta or secant theta. Now the question is, how will I know that I need to substitute only cosecant? What will happen if I substitute secant? Let's try out, no? Shall we try and see?
When it's 1 minus x square.
Root of x square minus 1. I will put x is equal to secant theta instead of cosecant theta. Then I'll have cot inverse of 1 divided by root of secant square theta minus 1. So cot inverse of how much?
1 by tan square theta.
1 by tan theta. So this will become cot inverse of cot theta, which is nothing but theta. But what is theta, guys? Is it not secant inverse? So here also you are getting the same answer. So irrespective of whether you substitute secant theta or cosecant theta, the answer is still secant inverse x, but you should know the difference when to substitute secant or cosecant. When it is x square minus 1, not even root. Wherever you see x square minus 1, you will put x is equal to secant or cosecant. Right? Shall I move on?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next. Prove that tan inverse x plus tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square is equal to tan inverse of 3x minus x cube by 1 minus 3x square. Simple. So tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, what is the formula? Tan inverse of x plus y, the whole divided by 1 minus x into, correct? So tan inverse of x minus x cube plus 2x, the whole divided by 1 minus x square. This whole thing is divided by 1 minus x square minus 2x square divided by 1 minus x square. So 1 minus x square, 1 minus x square in the denominators get cancelled. You will have tan inverse of x plus 2x is going to give you 3x minus x cube divided by 1 minus 3x square. Clear? Right. So moving on to the next one. Eighth one. Find the value of cos of secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x. One step answer. Cos of, just now we did a problem. Secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is going to give you
pi by 2.
Yes. Cos pi by 2 is 0. That's the answer. That's why they told find the value of it. Okay. You need not sit and do all these things. You can just say using property number 4, secant inverse 6 plus cosecant inverse 6, 5 by 2, sorry. Now the next question is, sine inverse of sine of 3 pi by 5. So this is where the trick starts. So how to solve this? See, I have already told this to you guys. Sine inverse of sine x is x. Sine of sine inverse x is also x. Here for all values of x that belongs to, tell me.
Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2.
Very good. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Here the value of x belongs to?
Pi by 2.
Pi by.
Minus 1 to 1. Because inside sine inverse, you will substitute the value, no? So this is from the first in this concept. So sine inverse of sine 3 pi by 5, most common mistake is people will write it as 3 pi by 5. Because they assume that sine inverse of sine x is always x. It is always applicable when the value of x, when the value of the angle is lying between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So our duty is to check whether this is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So what is the value of 3 pi by 5 da? So pi by 5 is how much? 180 divided by 5 is?
75.
180 by 5 is
75.
108, sir.
3 pi by 5.
35, da. 180 by 5 is how much? 45, no?
36, sir.
36, sir. Okay, 108 degrees, yes. So it is 108, which is greater than pi by 2. So if you write the answer as 3 pi by 5, it is not accepted. So what are we supposed to do?
We have to apply the formulas.
What? You don't have any formula here. You need
divide into two values, sir. Yes, like x plus y.
You need to break up the 3 pi by 5 and write. You need to find a different angle which will give you the same value as that of sine 3 pi by 5. But that angle should be less than 90 degrees. So how do we find?
Sir, we have to divide the into two fractions.
So you have to break it into two fractions. How are we going to break it?
Sir, 2 pi by 5 plus pi by 5.
2 pi by 5
plus pi by 5.
See, whenever you are breaking into fractions, no, this is not the way you go. Because this doesn't make sense. Okay, good that you try, but that's not the way you do it. You should always break it into this kind of a format. I remember you asking me, like in one of the classes, you asked me, sir, how to solve sine 765, something like this, you asked me, no?
Yes, sir.
I will touch those concepts and come, okay? So, if I have to write the sine of 765, in terms of acute angle, what should I do? So, I will divide the 765 with a multiple of 360, which is close to it. So, what is the multiple of 360, which is close to 765?
720.
Yes. So can I write it as sine of 720 plus 45? Right?
Yes.
So try to understand, if I complete one revolution, if I start from this point, I am again coming back to the same point, I have completed 360 degrees. If I do another rotation, I have completed 720 degrees. So to the 720 degrees, if I complete 45 more degrees, I'll be somewhere in the angular bisector of this quadrant. Right?
Yes, sir.
So sine 720 plus 45 is nothing but sine 45. That is 1 by root. In a okay. Similar, what is the value of sine 3 pi by 5, which is going to give me the same value as that of it? So that's what I need to think of. Okay. So I'll explain the method. So here what I explained is with respect to angle in terms of degrees. For example, had the question been sine 13 pi by I'll take it like this. I'll take 3 pi by 5 itself. I'll take sine 3 pi by 5 itself. So then how can I break and write it? So 3 pi by 5 is going to be where?
Second quadrant, sir.
It's going to be in second quadrant, but sine inverse is saying I can choose the angles only from the first and the fourth quadrant. So 108 is going to be somewhere over here. If I take a protractor and measure, it is going to be somewhere over here. But my job is to convert this into this quadrant. So how am I going to do it? Okay. So the logic is very simple. Whenever you have a multiple of pi, no, look for the fraction. So if the fraction, I'm repeating it, if the fraction is less than 1, that is, if the numerator is less than the denominator, then write it like this. So 3 pi, try to write, so 3, right, try to write it in terms of the denominator. So I will write it as 5 pi minus, how much should I do to get 3 pi?
Wait, so it should be 2 pi, pi minus 2 pi by 5.
You're able to understand? So that if I split the denominator to each term, then I'll get sine of pi minus 2 pi by 5. Now I know the fact that sine of pi minus theta is sine theta. So this is same as sine 2 pi by 5. Guys, are you able to understand? A very, very, very important point.
Yes.
Right. Now what I'm trying to say is sine 3 pi by 5 can also be written as pi minus 2 pi by 5. So that is nothing but sine inverse of sine of 2 pi by 5. Now check whether 2 pi by 5 is less than 90. That is 36 into 2, which is 72. So sine inverse of sine 2 pi by 5 can be written as 2 pi by 5. So it is no more the answer, no more the answer is 3 pi by 5, it is going to be 2 pi by 5. Are you guys able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the answer is 2 pi by 5.
Could you go down a bit?
Yeah. Okay, shall I move on to the next one? Now see. Show that sine inverse of 3 pi by 5 minus sine inverse of 8 by 17 is cos inverse of 84 divided by 85. Okay, how to solve this? So this will be the last example problem, then we'll go to the exercise. Because all these are from miscellaneous. So, solution C. Sine inverse of 3 pi by 5, if I take it as theta, then what is sine theta? 3 pi by 5. I'll do one thing. I'll take it as alpha. Okay. So, I'm going to take a right angle triangle. If I call this as alpha, then this side is 3 and this side is 5. Am I clear? Then how much will be? It is 4 because 3, 4, 5 are Pythagorean triplets. Similarly, sine inverse of 8 by 17, if I call it as beta, then sine beta is how much?
8 by 17.
8 by 17. So if I take this as beta, this is 8, this is 17. How much will this be?
15, sir.
Right, no? It is 289 minus 64, which is 225. Yes, it is 15. Right. The reason why I took this triangle is because we don't have a formula for sine inverse x minus sine inverse y. Rather, we have a formula for tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Right? So if sine alpha is 3 by 5, then what is going to be the value of tan alpha, guys? Look at the triangle and tell me, no, is it not 3 by 4?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, tan beta is going to be 8 by 15.
8 by 15.
15. Right. So sine inverse 3 by 5 is alpha, sine inverse 8 by 17 is beta. So alpha is nothing but tan inverse of 3 by 4, and beta is nothing but tan inverse of 8 by 15. So alpha minus beta, I can write it as tan inverse of 3 by 4 minus tan inverse of 8 by 15. So how much is it going to be, guys? So it will be tan inverse of
x plus y
3 by 4 minus 8 by 1 minus 3 by 4 into 8 by 15. So once you solve this, you will get the answer as tan inverse of something known.
Sir, 1 plus. No.
Can you solve it and tell me? Make it first.
Sir, 1 plus 3 by 4 into 8 by 15. No.
Make it first. Solve and tell me. Just a minute, guys. I need to connect my charger. Is it that tough? So it is 45 minus 32 divided by
60, sir.
60 plus 24, 84, no? Tan inverse of 13 divided by 84, correct?
Yes,
so 13,
yes, sir.
Does it go?
13 by 84.
So tan inverse of 13 by 84. So if you take the triangle like this, then if I call this as gamma, so tan inverse of 13 by 84 means opposite divided by adjacent. Then if you try to calculate, this should come out as 85. Then cos of gamma will be equal to A, which implies gamma will be equal to cos inverse of 84 by 85. Did you guys understand what I did?
Yes, sir.
So I know this is a slightly tough problem. Still, you guys are not ready, but it's okay. You could learn something, no? So now we'll go to the exercise. Okay, you need some more practice to come to the stage. So exercise will be simple, okay? Don't get scared. So the first one, prove that 3 sine inverse x is equal to sine inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. So consider RHS, sine inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. So what should I put x as? It is looking in which form? It's looking the form 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. What is 3 sine? What is 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta?
This sine 3 theta.
Sine 3 theta. So put x is equal to sine theta, substitute it here. So sine inverse of 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta is going to be sine inverse of sine 3 theta. So sine inverse of sine 3 theta is 3 theta. So when you put x as sine theta, theta will be sine inverse x.
Sine
theta.
Inverse.
So bring it here and substitute. The answer will
3
be
3 sine inverse x.
Yes.
Yes,
simple?
Yes, sir.
So I'm moving on to the next one. You guys do this. Prove that 3 cos inverse x is equal to cos inverse of 4x cube minus 3x. So take RHS, what will you substitute the value of x as?
Cos 3 theta.
Guys, what will you substitute the value?
3 cos theta. Sorry, cos 3 theta.
Yes, 4x cube minus 3x. No, you will put x
answer is cos 3 theta. Cos inverse x.
Yes, theta will be cos inverse x. So substitute it here. So cos inverse of 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. So cos inverse of 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta is cos 3 theta. So this will be 3 theta 3 times cos inverse of x. Okay. This one I hope you guys can do it. 2 minutes time, do it fast. Tan inverse of 2 by 11 plus tan inverse of 7 by 24. So you take LHS. That will be tan inverse of how much? X plus, in the exam don't forget to write the formula. X plus y divided by 1 minus x into y. So what will be the answer? Tan inverse of 48 plus 77 divided by 24 into 11 minus 14. So how much is this term? Tan inverse of 48 plus 77. 15, 1, 125 divided by 24 elevens is how much, sir? 24 tens is 240, 240 plus 24 is
264
minus 262. So 262 minus 14 is going to be?
Sir, 264, no, sir.
264
minus 14 is 250. So 125, yeah. 125 divided by 250, that is tan inverse of half. Simple. This is the one you need to be careful. Solution. See, you have 2 tan inverse half plus tan inverse of 1 by 7. One of the options that you can do use is this 2 tan inverse half, you can write it as tan inverse half plus tan inverse half. That is, you will get tan inverse half plus tan inverse half plus tan inverse of 1 by 7. So you can add these two and you will get a tan inverse value. Again, do tan inverse x plus tan inverse y between those two. Or the other method is, we know a formula that 2 tan inverse x is nothing but tan inverse of how much? The last property, last one. 2x divided by?
2x divided by 1 minus x square.
Minus x square. If it is 1 plus x square, it is sine inverse. Okay, well? So 2 tan inverse half is nothing but tan inverse of how much, star? 2 into half divided by 1 minus 1 by 4. Cancel it. That will be tan inverse of 1 divided by 3 by 4, which will be tan inverse of 4 by 3.
Oh, sorry.
Right. So tan inverse of 4 by 3 plus tan inverse of 1 by 7 is how much?
Tan inverse of x 4 by 3 plus 1 by 7 by 1 minus 4 by 3 into 1 by 3.
So tan inverse of cross multiply 28 plus 3. See, I'm comfortable with cross multiplication rather than taking LCM, because if I cross multiply, denominators will get cancelled. So tan inverse of 31 divided by 17. Right? I hope you guys would understand.
I have a doubt.
Yeah, tell me.
So if an RHS is given sine theta in terms of sine or cos, we substitute accordingly, right? Here, since it's tan in the RHS, we use the tan formula.
I had they asked?
In the terms of sine or cos.
I don't know. Is it network issue my side? Is my voice clear to you guys?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Yes, sir.
Is everyone able to hear Rohan properly?
Yes,
I'm
sir.
Not able to hear.
Yes, sir.
Your voice is breaking down. Can you put it in the chat box? I'll wait for it. Can you put it in the chat box? I'll wait and read it out for others also. sir, if RHS was in terms of sine or cos, then we substitute. No need to substitute. See, had the right side been sine inverse of something, you're still going to use the same formula for tan inverse. Once you get tan inverse of third, so his question, everyone listen, no? He's saying, sir, if RHS was in terms of sine or cos, then we substitute accordingly, right? We need not substitute anything. You will still do it with tan inverse x plus tan inverse y because that is the only formula that you have. See, though there are formula for sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, but not for CBSE. That is not explained. That is the reason I'm not going in depth. Too many formula will confuse you, okay? So you derive it in terms of sine tan inverse 31 by 17 only. Then draw a right angle triangle. So when you draw a right angle triangle, what are you going to get? You are clearly, you will be able to understand that
opposite
this is 30 and this is 17, then this is nothing but root of 31 square plus 17 square. Now you can write sine inverse accordingly. Sine inverse of 31 divided by root of 31 square plus 17 square, whatever that value is. Or if the answer is in terms of cos, you will write as cos inverse of 17 divided by root of 31 square plus 17 square. Rohan, I hope you are clear. Okay, good. Next. Write the function in its simplest form. Tan inverse of root of 1 by x square minus 1 by x. So again, go back, revisit the notes. I have given you a method. Wherever you see 1 plus x square, what are you supposed to substitute? Put
secant x or cosecant x. Sorry.
Tan theta or cot theta.
We'll substitute tan theta or cot theta. Okay, substitute it here because 1 plus tan square theta is secant square theta. Correct? So tan inverse of root of 1 plus tan square theta minus 1 divided by tan theta. So tan inverse of root of 1 plus tan square theta is how much term? Secant square theta. So under the root will give you secant theta minus 1 divided by, you have a tan theta in the denominator. This is where the problem starts. Observe. Tan inverse of secant theta is 1 by cos theta minus 1 divided by tan theta is sine theta by cos theta. Okay, basic thing I manipulation I did. So if I take LCM, it will be tan inverse of what?
1 minus cos theta.
1 minus cos theta divided by sine theta. So that will give me tan inverse of 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine square theta by 2 divided by sine theta can be written as 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. 1 sine is gone. So you will get the answer as tan inverse of tan theta by 2. The answer is theta by 2. So what is the value of theta, guys? From here I know theta is equal to tan inverse of x. So what will be the answer? Half into tan inverse x. Don't write it as tan inverse of x by 2. This is wrong. Okay, it is half into tan inverse x and this is right. Is there anyone who is finding it difficult? I'm moving on to the next problem. So half tan inverse. So tan inverse of 1 by root of x square minus 1. So now you tell me that x is equal to secant theta or cosecant theta. It is up to you. So tan inverse of 1 divided by what should I write? Root of secant square theta minus 1. So that will be tan inverse of 1 by how much?
Tan square theta.
So 1 by under root tan square theta, that is tan theta. So that will be tan inverse of cot theta.
Cot theta.
Tan inverse of cot theta will not get eliminated. So I need to write cot theta as tan of pi by 2 minus theta. So answer would be pi by 2 minus theta. And what is the value of theta?
Secant inverse x.
Secant inverse x. So pi by 2 minus secant inverse x is how much? From property number 4.
Cosecant inverse x.
Secant inverse x. Now the question is, see, I want to teach one more thing, guys. See, what will happen, you will, since I'm substituting x is equal to secant theta in this problem, you should start assuming that we need to substitute only as secant theta. Don't memorize it. You guys try it with what will happen when you substitute cosecant theta. If you substitute cosecant theta, can you do those steps in mind and tell me? Alternate. So tan inverse of 1 by root of cosecant square theta minus cot square theta. So tan inverse of 1 by root of cot theta is 1 by cot theta. That will become tan theta. What is the answer?
Tan theta. So it will be theta, sir.
Theta. But what did you substitute theta as?
Cot theta.
You substituted x equal to cosecant theta. So theta will be?
Secant inverse x.
Secant
inverse. You will get the same answer, okay? You should get. It's not like you will. You should get the same answer. If you're not getting, then it is a mathematical error. That will never happen. Okay, they left it as pi by 2 minus secant inverse x. But yes, you can write it as secant inverse. Cosecant inverse. So tan inverse of root of 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x. Simple. 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x. If I have to tell you directly, this is nothing but tan square x by 2. You guys know this? Very simple. 1 minus cos x is 2 sin square x by 2. 1 plus cos x is 2 cos square x by 2. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. It is tan square x by 2. Okay. So what will be the answer? Tan inverse of root of tan square x by 2 is how much? That is tan inverse of tan x by 2, and the answer will be x by 2. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next. Tan inverse of cos x minus sin x divided by cos x plus sin x. Okay. So what am I supposed to do is divide numerator and denominator with cos x. If I divide the numerator and denominator with cos x, then I'll get tan inverse of
1 minus tan x.
1 minus tan x divided by
1 plus.
Perfect. We did a similar problem in the last class, if you remember. So you'll get 1 minus tan x divided by 1 plus tan x. This, I told you, what is this?
Sin 2x.
That is 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. Square theta is cos 2x. Sin 2x. Here it is 1 minus tan x by 1 plus tan x. This is tan of pi by 4 minus x. So this is nothing but pi by 4 minus x. But what is the value of x? So that's it. This is the simplest form. This is an important formula you have to remember. So I now, from your answer, I understood there is a confusion. 1 minus tan square x by 1 plus tan square x. If it is square, it is cos 2x. If there is no square, it is tan of pi by 4 minus x. It is tan of pi by 4 minus x if the minus is in the numerator. Sometimes you will get a scenario like this. 1 plus tan x by 1 minus tan x. Then how much is this? This is tan of pi by 4.
Pi by 4 minus plus x.
Plus x. So if you know this point, well and good. If you don't know, please make a note. If you still have a doubt, let me know. you're still not clear with something, please let me know. So you're clear?
Yes, sir.
So, write the function in the simplest form. Tan inverse of x divided by root of a square minus x square. This also I told you. You will put the value of x as
a sin theta or a cos theta.
Right. Substitute it here. So, tan inverse of, I will put a sin theta divided by root of a square minus a square sin square theta. So tan inverse of how much, guys? A sin theta divided by root of a square into 1 minus sin square theta. So tan inverse of a sin theta divided by how much is it? It is a cos theta. So tan inverse of tan theta, that is theta, right? So if I put x is equal to a sin theta, observe this, no, which implies x by a is sin theta, then how much is theta? It is sin inverse of x by a. So the final answer will be sin inverse of x divided by a. Next, shall I move on?
Yes, sir.
So sine inverse x by a. Write the function in its simplest form, solution. Tan inverse of 3a square x minus x cube by a cube minus 3ax. We will put x is equal to anybody. So there is a formula like this. Tan 3 theta is equal to 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta. So you guys compare and tell me what am I supposed to substitute in the place of x.
Tan theta.
Tan theta.
No.
Tan theta by a square.
You have to substitute as a tan theta. If you substitute a tan theta, then this will become a cube, this will become a cube. A cube is already there, this will also become a cube. Okay. When you substitute x is equal to a tan theta, that implies tan theta is equal to x divided by a. And theta is equal to how much? Tan inverse of x divided by a. Okay. So tan inverse of 3a cube tan theta minus a cube tan cube theta divided by a cube minus 3a cube tan square theta. So what will be, what is common in numerator and denominator?
A cube.
So can I write this as 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta? That is going to give me tan inverse of tan 3 theta, which is 3 theta. But what is theta, guys? Where did I write? 3 times tan inverse of x divided by a. So this is the formula. Sorry, this is the answer for this formula. Okay. Next. This is a good one. Solution. tan inverse of 2 times cos of 2 sin inverse of half. So I need to find the value. Okay, when you face these kind of problems, look at the inverse trigonometric function that is outside. So look at the inverse trigonometric function that is outside. It is tan inverse. So when they say value, they are asking you for the final number that you are going to get. So I will be able to find the final number if I am able to express whatever is inside this inverse function in terms of what?
In terms of tan x.
I should convert everything in terms of tan. So the thing I need to start with is I should start from the right extreme. Observe, we know this point, no? What is 2 sine inverse of half equal to? So actually, there is a simple problem. You need not complicate it. There is a very, very simple problem. What is sine inverse half done? From the basics of first exercise.
30, sir.
Radians I want, pi by 6. Okay. So tan inverse of 2 cos of 2 into sin inverse of half is pi by 6. So 2 and 6 will get cancelled 3 times. So you will have tan inverse of 2 cos of how much?
Pi by 3.
So tan inverse of 2 into cos pi by 3 is half. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Tan inverse of 1 is how much? Tan inverse of 1, Ram. Pi by 4. Okay.
Sir, last show that, sir.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, sorry. Is it okay? Is it clear?
It's just a minute.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now listen. It's the last problem. Find the value of cot of tan inverse A plus cot inverse A. So cot of, we know a simple identity, property number 4. Tan inverse X plus cot inverse X.
It's equal to
pi by 2.
So cot pi by 2 is 0. That's it. So cos pi by 2 is 0. I think we can do one last problem and then wind up. So solution. Tan half of sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square plus cos inverse of 1 minus y square by 1 plus y square. So tan of half into, tell me that, sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square is 2 times tan inverse of
x
plus cos inverse of 1 minus y square by 1 plus y square is 2 times tan inverse of
Y.
So what is common? 2. So 2
will tan inverse.
So tan of tan inverse X plus tan inverse Y. How much stuff? Tan of
tan inverse
plus Y by
X 1 minus Y.
So answer will be X plus Y divided by 1 minus X. Sure. Simple problem. Okay. So the remaining problems I want you guys to try. Tomorrow we have a class, no? I'll do it in tomorrow's class. So if you're not confident with any of the formulae, revisit your textbook, like a 11th standard textbook. And the videos have been uploaded for your reference. You can always have a cross verification. By tomorrow, ensure you have a short notes of all the formulae from your 11th standard trigonometry for you to understand these things better. Okay, so that's it from my side, guys. So I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir. Can you hear me? Raghavi, is it
Anandita? Yes, sir. Sir, I'm new here. Like, I joined today only. Like, this is the first class. So I guess you've completed only.